From CVP here in Cincinnati, Ohio, it's the Doc to Doc podcast. Short videos to keep you up to date and connected to CVP physicians across the country. I'm Dr. Lori Provencher. Welcome back. I'd like to introduce Dr. Arjun Sood. He is a vitreoretinal specialist and uveitis specialist at Cincinnati Eye Institute. So Dr. Sood, there's tons of updates within retina and uveitis right now. We could be here for days, but I really want to tap into your knowledge on uveitis. So a topic that's relevant to a lot of CVP physicians is cataract surgery and uveitics. So take us through kind of how you think about these patients. I'd like to start with the pre-op period. How do you approach them before cataract surgery?
Sure. Well, thank you so much for having me here. You know, no matter how perfectly a surgery goes, it is so essential to control inflammation both preoperatively and postoperatively. Standard for all of my patients undergoing any surgery, but in particular cataract surgery, is 3 months of quiescent or inactive disease. I also tend to augment therapy about a week before surgery, and this can be done in a couple of ways. One option is to give oral prednisone 40 to 60 milligrams daily, 1 week leading up to surgery. But my other preference is to augment with intravitreal steroids, either the dexamethasone implant or triesence.
Okay, so that local option's nice for, say, your diabetics or patients that oral steroids might not be a good option for?
Absolutely.
Okay, so preoperatively, very specific things we can follow, which is great. What about intraoperatively? How do you manage them? Is there anything you do special?
Certainly. So if for some reason I can't start them on oral prednisone beforehand or they can't make it into the office for an injection, I will augment with intraoperative corticosteroids. I think IV solumedrol is an excellent option. Dosing can range from 500 milligrams to 1,000 milligrams, sort of as a stress dose.
Anything local though, like subconj or intracameral?
Certainly. Subtenon's Kenalog is an excellent option and adjunct as well after surgery.
Where things really become a little more challenging is postoperatively. So what are you doing for them post-op? Are you ever using non-steroidals, for example?
So my mainstay is topical steroids or oral prednisone, but I think topical NSAIDs are an excellent adjunct as well, especially if the patient develops CME. Adding topical ketorolac or an alternative NSAID is an excellent option.
Right, so the reason I bring that up is because some people think, you know, non-steroidals might help taper the steroids faster or affect how long patients need to be on them. Is there any data to support any of that?
There's really not great data. I think a lot of this is just voodoo and kind of how you want to approach the patient. I will routinely not taper both of the drops at the same time. I may just taper the topical steroids and then keep the NSAID at full strength.
Right. As a glaucoma specialist, I love non-steroidal, so I had to ask.
Yeah, absolutely. Right.
So, speaking of glaucoma, I have to ask, MIGS have become very popular for uveitics or steroid responders. Do you have any strong feelings one way or another about using MIGS for these patients?
I think MIGS has been a great surgical addition to our management of patients with uveitic glaucoma. So many of my patients develop glaucoma. I'm causing it because of my local steroids or retisurts. So I think it's been a fantastic addition. In particular, angle-based surgery has been shown to be pretty beneficial. For example, the Kahook dual blade has been shown to be very effective in uveitic patients in helping lower intraocular pressure when they're already on max therapy. It also can delay glaucoma drainage implants or more invasive surgery. So I think it's an excellent option.
Right, it's always nice to have staged options for these patients because a lot of them are younger. And so not jumping right to filtration surgery is a really nice development, I think.
I agree.
So another common issue I think that comes up for cataract surgeons and the timing when they refer to uveitis are these patients that you can't quite get them off topical steroids after cataract surgery, sort of this chronic iritis. What recommendations do you have? When should we send these patients to you?
Sure, I routinely get patients sent to me with persistent postoperative inflammation or they've failed the typical 1 month standard taper. You know, it's important to take into account surgical factors. You know, was the iris manipulated? If hooks, rings, was there a synecholysis performed? Those are all things that can release pigment into the anterior chamber, and pigment is very pro-inflammatory. And so these patients will often require more prolonged steroids, up to even 3 months, for example. Then I take into account other potential causes of inflammation postoperatively. Is there a potential chronic indolent infections such as P. acnes. I will also gonio these patients, looking in the angle for any retained lens fragments. That's also a potential cause of persistent inflammation. There's a couple other risk factors to consider. The African-American race, interestingly, has been shown to be a risk factor for persistent inflammation postoperatively. And then I also have patients who have known systemic autoimmune conditions, never had a history of uveitis, but the surgery itself can sort of precipitate an inflammatory episode. So
that
those
makes
are
sense.
Just a few things. Mm-hmm.
Like pro-inflammatory individuals, for sure.
Absolutely.
Okay, that's super helpful. So if these patients do end up in your office, are you doing a systemic workup or waiting until something else comes along?
When I first meet the patient, I am not initially doing a systemic workup unless something on review system is making me suspicious. I usually attribute the inflammation to the recent surgery. If things aren't heading in the right direction, if they've developed worsening inflammation, then I will order a targeted laboratory workup.
What about the patient that has a very distant history of uveitis, no recent episodes, but you know about it? Do you approach them a little differently?
Yeah, I treat each patient individually. In the example that you've given, I would treat them perhaps just with topical steroids preoperatively. You know, there's not a lot of great data behind this. A lot of this is sort of medical common sense, so to speak. To try and manage a flare after it's happened is much more difficult than potentially preventing it altogether. I try to be proactive rather than reactive.
Right, that makes sense. So I think it goes without saying that the common theme here, or the theme that unifies all of this, is one, managing patient expectations, because they're not going to be a typical pre, intra-op, or post-op course. And then also really communicating with a uveitis specialist when you need to, or if they already have an established provider.
It's so important to counsel the patients preoperatively. This is not routine cataract surgery. Their visual expectations may be completely different. They may have very advanced optic nerve damage, advanced retinal damage. The surgery itself may require a longer surgery. You may want to consider retrobulbar block, especially if you're manipulating the iris pretty extensively. Those are just a few pearls to consider.
Great, that's super helpful. You've given us a lot of really good recommendations. And so hopefully we can take these things back to our practice and be a little more proactive than reactive. So thanks so much for coming today.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.